imagine cruising into 2024 armed with your very own iOS developer roadmap. It's like having a trusted guide through the wild, ever-changing terrain of app development. This roadmap isn't just a piece of paper. It's your secret weapon to staying on top of the game. Picture it as your personalized treasure map leading you through the latest iOS updates, cutting-edge frameworks, and all the cool tech that's popping up. It's not just about code. It's about your journey, your goals, and seeing your progress unfold. So, buckle up. 2024 is the year your iOS development adventure goes next level. And to make sure you kick off this year the right way, check out the link in the description to master SWIFTUI in 4 weeks. There's a 75% off discount and there's only one seat left. So we are going to learn SWIFTUI in 4 weeks with the basics, navigation, Swift data, and your SWIFTUI, where you can have your SWIFTUI questions answered. And here are all of the testimonials that previously took SWIFTUI Camp. Go ahead and check out. It's the link in the description. Today, we are going to kick off this year by talking about the iOS developer complete roadmap for 2024. And I've been doing this for more than 13 years, actually nearly 14 years now. I've been developing for the iOS platform and of course macOS as it came out. And I've been doing this roadmap for a few years now, and this is the most comprehensive one. We will have links and explanations why you need to do all of these. So also check out the captions down below if you want to skip any of the stages. But let's just dive down into the basics. So we are going to start off this year with the basics. And if you are an iOS developer, maybe an experienced iOS developer, make sure to revisit all of these. It doesn't hurt to check out what you already kind of covered, but maybe you forgot some things. So the basics. We are going to check out source control. Source control is one of the most important parts that you need to master as not just an iOS developer or a developer for the Apple platforms, as a developer in general. So I recommend GitHub. There's also Bitbucket, and GitHub is by far the most popular one that developers use. So make sure that you also have a GitHub account and you create projects there. It's also a good way to showcase your potential, your knowledge. You can just build out example apps, what you think that is really showcase for your talent, and you can store them on GitHub. And whenever a recruiter comes along, or maybe if you are doing contract work, you can also point your clients over there. Ever wondered what the future of iOS development looks like? Well, it's written in SWIFTUI. This isn't just a framework. It's a game changer, making UI development smoother, more intuitive, and downright enjoyable. Imagine crafting sleek interfaces with less code, more flexibility, and real-time previews. SWIFTUI isn't just a step forward. It's a giant leap into the future of app design. Now, picture this. You at the forefront of this revolution. That's why you should jump on board SWIFTUI Camp, where innovation meets affordability. Join now at a whopping 75% off and let's redefine the way we build apps together. The camp starts this Thursday and seats are open till Wednesday night. The discounted link is down in the description. Now, Xcode is the next big step that you want to master, because Xcode is the way of building iOS apps, well, basically Apple platform apps. I know you can use also VS Code. Check out one of my previous videos. But eventually, after you code it in VS Code or maybe some other IDE, you are going to need Xcode to submit to the App Store, to maybe debug it better, to profile it, all of that stuff. So Xcode is one of the most important things that you have to learn as a basics. And by the way, You can find this roadmap in the description under the resources, and all of these are clickable. So you can just click on these and you will be taken to the link, to the appropriate link. Now, Swift is Apple's new language after Objective-C. I started off, honestly, with Objective-C. It was a pain to work with, but as soon as Swift came out, I just abandoned Objective-C and I was 100% on Swift. So you need to know the Swift programming language. Also, again, take a look at the link right over here to get started with Swift. Maybe you are just going to need a refresher, of course, but it's always a good thing to do all of this stuff in January to just start the year with a bang. Okay, so next up is the foundation. You want to make sure that you have a good programming foundation. And because we are talking about iOS development, about Apple platforms, you need to master the human interface guidelines. These are the guidelines that Apple has for you to build out magnificent apps for their platform. They will reject your app if you don't adhere to the human interface guidelines. You are going to learn a lot of what it means, what it feels to build out an iOS application from these guidelines. So every year I just go through all of these guidelines. Maybe they just added some new stuff. But if this is the first time you are going to go through it, it's quite a lot of stuff. But you know, just take it one step at a time and try to build your interface to the human interface guidelines according to that. Okay, another really important thing as the foundation is data structures and algorithms. And you can practice algorithms on LeetCode. I highly recommend you take a look at like the basics, questions. I believe there's something like top 75 or top 50. Just go to LeetCode and you will find it over there and just go through all of that. Now, of course, you also need data structures. So to learn data structures, to understand data structures. And there's also a course on that. It's a paid one. But I highly recommend to subscribing to LeetCode. Now, this is not a paid sponsored video of any kind by anybody. But I highly recommend that you jump on board because there are also video tutorials on how to solve those problems. And you know, you can just then reverse engineer or just take a look at the videos and try it out yourself. I recommend for algorithms to be practice LeetCode. Okay, next up is UI. And you know, there are two separate ways to very, very different ways of building out UI for the Apple platforms. And the first one, and the oldest one, actually, is UIKit / AppKit, because AppKit is for macOS apps and UIKit is for iPhone apps, basically. UIKit has been around for years and years, like since the introduction of the iPhone. It is well tested, robust, works every time. So it's really the go-to for many developers and many companies and many companies. First of all, because they have started, or maybe they just want to have a robust framework to work with UI on their apps, they chose UIKit. And that's why you might want to learn UIKit. Now, there's a caveat here, because I suggest that you learn SwiftUI first, because SwiftUI is really, really easy to, you know, just to start off with. Now, there's a big difference between the two of them. UIKit is kind of the imperative framework. SwiftUI is the declarative one. So the reactive one. It's much easier, much more pleasurable to work with. And therefore, I just recommend SWIFTUI. I've been working in SWIFTUI since SWIFTUI 2 for, so, 3.5 years. It's been a while now that I haven't touched UIKit code. So I highly recommend. And also, check out the link in the description for my SWIFTUI Camp January cohort. There's a 75% off discount. Yeah, I'm just giving this away because, you know, it's Christmas, and I just want us to kick off the new year with this really, really amazing SWIFTUI camp. By the way, there are only 5 seats available, and 4 are already taken. So if you are interested, this is the time to act. Okay, so I won't talk about more about SWIFTUI because you can take a look at all of my videos on the channel because I just simply love SWIFTUI. Okay, so next up is persistence. You want to make sure that you get this right. Now, it depends on what you want to persist. Maybe it's just user's favorite color. Then app storage / user defaults will just do fine. But if you want a little bit more, maybe cross-device synchronization, maybe some server synchronization, so users may chat with each other, or, you know, data should be shared with different users, then you should check out Core Data for local persistence or CloudKit for server persistence. This is Apple's solution for that. Now, you could just use CloudKit for iCloud access, or you could enable you can enable iCloud when you are using Core Data. That's amazing. So just save to Core Data and it will automatically sync it to iCloud. Now there's a little bit of setup, but that's very, very easy. If you just need serverless, don't need Core Data, don't need local persistence, just use CloudKit. Also, because, you know, SWIFTUI is over here and Apple is trying to really, really push SWIFTUI, by the way, this year, Vision OS will be available to the public. So, and it is SWIFTUI only. So again, make sure to check out SWIFTUI Camp if you want to learn SWIFTUI in 4 weeks. Now, Swift Data is kind of a wrapper around Core Data. It blends in very, very well with SWIFTUI. It has all of these. It has all of these nice macros and property wrappers. And again, we are going to cover Swift Data in SWIFTUI Camp thoroughly. Go ahead and check out the link in the description for more details. What I also recommend, if you are not just an Apple fanboy, maybe you want to also launch your app on Android, maybe, or the web, then the choice would be, the first choice would be to use Firebase. It's a very well documented, robust service with not just data storage, it has also authentication, file storage, push notifications, cloud functions. So Firebase is really, really a versatile tool for your persistence. Also, Supabase is a competitor to Firebase. It has kind of the same features. It's much more an indie kind of app. It's the competitor to Firebase. Firebase is has been bought by Google, so it's really, really huge. But make sure to also check out Supabase if that will cover your needs. And then there's Vapor. So if you'd like to code only in Swift, then Vapor is the way to go in terms of building out your own backend. So Vapor helps a lot with that. Again, the link is right over here. Finally, once you've done all, built all of your UI, you want to test your application. You want to make sure that it's not just you that finds the bugs, also your testers will check your application out. That's where Test Flight comes along. It's, again, provided by Apple. It's really, really handy. You just upload to App Store Connect. And by the way, you also must learn a lot about App Store Connect. So, and one thing is Test Flight. you can just send your builds out to testers, either internal testers, external testers. I have a video on that. It's really, really popular on my channel, so make sure to check that out. Also, if you like to learn more about test flight. And finally, you also want to incorporate Crashlytics, because when you are testing it, you know, you're running it in Xcode, you will see some crashes and crash logs, and maybe you're just going to debug it with print, how many of the developers do. But once it's out in the wild, in test flight, or God forbid, it's in production and you have a lot of crashes, Crashlytics will help you quite a lot. Now, this is a product from Firebase, so that's why I said Firebase is really, really nice and versatile. It will help you a lot. And by the way, it's free, so it's really, really nice. So this is my complete iOS developer roadmap for 2024. The basics, foundation, UI, persistence, and testing. And if you want to learn more about SwiftUI development, make sure to check out the link in the description where you can enroll to master SwiftUI in 4 weeks. And if you don't really like building apps in Xcode, you want to prefer maybe VS Code, make sure to check out the link of that video right over here.